friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another weekly WW grocery haul. This week I hit up Trader Joe's and Fred Meyer, which is a Kroger store. I had quite a bit to get. I am so excited about what is on my meal plan and what I'm having for breakfast, lunch. Everything fun is coming your way, including the first episode in my fall baking series. So if you want to see what groceries I picked up for the upcoming week, then just stay tuned. So here is my haul from Fred Meyer, which is also a Kroger store. Next up will be what I picked up from Trader Joe's. So first I grabbed some of the Fresh Gourmet wonton strips. This is for an upcoming lunch for meal prep. I'm really excited about my lunch this week and I needed the wonton strips for that. Surprisingly, these are better in points than I thought. So really excited to add those for that crunch factor to my salad. Some sourdough bread, just regular full-size slices of bread, primarily for my husband. He's going to be doing egg salad for lunches this next week. Speaking of egg salad, I picked up a dozen large white eggs for him for the egg salad. And then, of course, I picked up my very favorite happy eggs for myself for the week, and then also for him if he wanted eggs throughout the week as well. Sesame seeds, this is for my upcoming lunch recipe. A can of cream of chicken soup. This is for a dinner recipe. Again, the healthy request is better tasting than the 98% fat-free and is the same points, if not less. So highly recommend the healthy request versus the 98% fat-free. Also, I picked this banana extract up, and the only reason that I grabbed this is because look, 50 cents on clearance. So I've been thinking about maybe making a banana protein shake, and I thought that this would add some delicious flavor with my devotion powder. So grab that just to have on hand. I had a buy one, get one free coupon for the Talking Rain. This is just your unsweetened flavored seltzer water. So I grabbed grapefruit and peach nectar. I just like to take these with me when I'm out on the road, if I'm traveling to houses or to show clients' homes. This is a huge bottle, so it lasts me the entire day, and it's really, really good. Also, some Kraft Parmesan and Romano, what I call grated shaky cheese. We have this for an upcoming recipe. We were completely out, so I really like the Kraft. I think it's the best brand. It's a little more expensive than your generic, but I think the flavor is a lot better, so I picked that up. Also, some mandarin oranges, no sugar added. I need this also for my lunch meal prep. I seriously cannot wait for my lunches. So I just grabbed this instead of a can, only because the canned ones are generally in juice and this is not. So I'll just use these little cups as my mandarin oranges. Also, some 90 calorie Pillsbury Crescent rolls. This is for my breakfast meal prep. Again, can't wait. This is going to be another great week of meal prep. So I needed the 90 calorie Crescent rolls for that. Jimmy Dean fully cooked turkey sausage crumbles. This is also for my breakfast meal prep. So I'll be sharing my meal plan and prep ideas with you guys at the end of the video. So definitely stay tuned for that. Per the use, a can of the fat-free Ready Whip. I still have about a half a can, but I don't ever want to run out. So I went ahead and picked up another can. Also, for my almond milk this week, I grabbed the Unsweetened Vanilla Almond Breeze Almond Cashew Creamy. This milk is so thick and creamy and delicious. I generally will add this to my coffee. Sometimes I use it in protein shakes. So I really like this one, so I grabbed that. And then I was so excited, I could hardly contain myself, that Fred Meyer now is carrying the sugar-free peppermint mocha creamer. I bought every single one they had, which is four. Tip on this, you guys, you can freeze these. So I plan on loading up my freezer with these to make it through at least half of this next year, because this is my all-time favorite coffee creamer in the entire world. I love it so much, it's so good. So I picked up four of those, and then of course next week, if they have more, I'll be grabbing some more of those. And again, throw them in your freezer, that way you have them on hand for the entire year. Also, some apple juice. Primarily, this is for my husband, but I do need this for an upcoming recipe. Just a small amount of it, so he'll drink the rest of it. And then the rest is produce or vegetables. So I have three bags of the Kroger California style veggies. So this is broccoli, carrots, and cauliflower. I need two bags for a recipe, and then I picked up a third bag just to have on hand for a side dish. and also the Kroger mixed veggies, again, just for a side dish for a vegetable. They have their peaches and nectarines on sale. Oh, that one doesn't look that great, does it? But anyways, they have their peaches and nectarines on sale for 99 cents a pound. So I picked up 6, that way I can have one every single day. 2 green apples for my lunch prep and an orange. Also excited to announce that my fall baking series is coming. My very first episode will be posted shortly. And actually, I forgot I didn't need these green apples for that and the orange. So I can't wait to share my first fall baking series recipe with you guys. So that is everything other than 2 cases of Diet Coke and a case of water that I picked up at Fred Meyer. So let's move into Trader Joe's. And here is what I picked up for the week at Trader Joe's. Mainly went there for produce because I love their produce. Their prices are outstanding. So here's what I grabbed. So of course, hence fall, I picked up some fall colored mums. You get this entire bouquet for $3.99. You cannot beat the price on flowers at Trader Joe's. So I'm gonna swap out my summery ones that are kind of on their last leg for these fall colored mums. Really excited. Also, I grabbed another bag of the Trader Joe's Light Mexican Blend. I need this for several recipes for the upcoming week. Really good points, only 2 smart points per 1 ounce or quarter cup versus 3 of other light cheeses. So really good deal if you have a Trader Joe's near you. Same with the Trader Joe's Organic Shredded Mozzarella. This cheese is pricey. It is $5 for an 8 ounce bag. But it is a great dupe for the light shredded mozzarella because it is only 2 points per 1 ounce. And I know the light shredded was 1, but this cheese is really, really good. And again, it's only 2 points per ounce or quarter of a cup. Also, some light string cheese. I need this for an upcoming air fryer recipe as well as for my lunches and just as a snack. Really, really good and only 1 smart point per stick. 2 more pounds of my extra lean 96.4 Trader Joe's ground beef, my favorite ground beef, hands down, great price, $5.49 a pound, which in my area is a fantastic price for 96.4 extra lean ground beef. Also for my lunches this week, I picked up another package of the Trader Joe's Just Chicken Strips. Literally, this is just frozen grilled chicken. It tastes really good, so I'm gonna be using this on my salads for my lunches for the upcoming week. Speaking of salads, I did grab quite a bit of lettuce, so I picked up this Champs Elysis. I don't know how you pronounce that, but it is green leaf lettuce, frisée, radicchio, and carrots. And I'm gonna mix that with the Organic Power Greens, which is organic baby kale, chard, and spinach. And then I also picked up a pack of the Organics Romaine. So I'm gonna be mixing all 3 of these together for my salads for lunches. Grabbed a big bag of I'm a bag of Trader Joe's Gold potatoes. This is a 3-pound bag. I need potatoes in a couple of recipes this next week. So great deal, like less than $3 for this bag at Trader Joe's. My favorite Brussels sprouts from the frozen section, 99 cents a bag. This is a 1-pound package for $1, and these baby Brussels sprouts are so good. So I grabbed 2 of those. Unsalted, dry, toasted, sliced almonds. This is for my salads. I'm really excited. So I was wavering between these or the regular sliced almonds, and I thought, why not get them already toasted? Save me a step. Same price, a little bit better flavor, same points. So I grabbed that at Trader Joe's. Also, some asparagus. I need this for an upcoming recipe. Asparagus is about out of season, I feel like, so it's looking pretty good still. So wanted to do this recipe while the asparagus was still good. Really excited. I grabbed another bag of cute little Sesame Street Eat Brighter lemons. So this is just a big bag of lemons. I've been really enjoying lemon water. Kind of a new thing for me, but I've been loving it. I use 1 lemon a day basically in several cups of water. So I grabbed that. Also, I picked up this Anderson Organics sweet onions. This is a big bag of sweet onions. To be honest, this was a better price than regular onion. So if I were to just grab onions bulk, it would have been a lot more expensive. This entire bag of organic onions was only $2.79. So this will definitely last me a while. And honestly, I prefer the smaller onions anyways. I feel like I can just use a whole onion in a recipe instead of trying to preserve it and put it in the fridge and hope it doesn't go bad for a second recipe. So excited about that. And the last hurrah in watermelon, I think this is about the end of watermelon season. So I picked up this big watermelon, $3.99 at Trader Joe's. So that's everything that I grabbed at Trader Joe's for the week. So let's get into my meal plan and what's on the plan for prep. So let's go over what is on the plan for meals for the upcoming week. This is my absolutely beautiful Carrie L meal planner. As you know, I love, love, love it. So it is the 8.5 by 11 size of the meal planner. It's gorgeous. It's comprehensive. You have several tabs to help you stay on track and plan your meals. So first there is the resources tab. This is where you can jot down your favorite meal planning blogs and recipe sites, just to kind of have everything in one spot for you. There's also the inventory section. I'm excited about this. I actually just reorganized my pantry, fridge, and freezer yesterday. So next on my list is to inventory those items. So there is a spot for freezer inventory, pantry inventory, and whoops, I skipped past it here, and spices inventory. And this is nice because spices expire sometimes before we have the opportunity to use them. And this is gonna be a great tool for you to track the expiration date. Also, we'll come back to the meal plans tab. There is the gatherings tab. That is where you can plan out your gatherings. So if you have some sort of an event, especially with the holidays coming up, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, you can plan out what is on your meal plan for that event. And then there's also a detachable grocery list that you can take with you to the grocery store. So it just makes planning your life a lot easier. And last, before we hit the meal plans tab, is the notes tab. And that is just where you can jot down notes. You could even make lists and things on this section as well, but I generally use this as an area to write recipes down that I don't have printed or screenshotted. I do want to show you really quickly in the back of your meal planner, you have these great little folders. There's one on each side, and that allows you just to store printables and things like that in your meal planner. So let's go back to the meal plan tab, because that's actually where we're going to spend a little bit of time. Let's fast forward to the current month. I cannot believe, you guys, it's September already. Crazy to me. So September, you have by a glance the monthly meal planner. This is so nice. It allows you to jot down what you are having for breakfast, lunch, dinner, however you want to use it. You can see it at a glance. You'll know what's on your plan for the following day. You can make sure that you not only have the ingredients on hand, but you also have the meat pulled out of the freezer. So I love the monthly planner. Love it. So for the week, you have what's called a weekly planner. So you have a weekly menu day by day where you can plan out your meals. I generally just use this for dinner because, as you know, I meal prep, so I don't prepare separate breakfasts and lunches each day. And then the detachable grocery list, that is something that I always, always, always use each week, is the grocery list. So let's move into this week. So my week goes Saturday through Friday. You can see the grocery list is gone because I did use it this morning at the grocery store. So Saturday is the day that I use my weekly. So I always go out to some sort of a meal, breakfast, lunch, or dinner. So I don't actually plan to prepare a dinner for that night. Tomorrow, I'm going to be making sheet pan steakhouse dinner. I'm really excited to share this with you guys. You will see this in my upcoming What I Eat in a Day video. Monday is a rollover recipe from last week that I didn't quite get to, just had a kind of a crazy week. If you haven't checked out my weigh-in video that I posted last Friday, definitely check that out, or yesterday I should say, definitely check that out because I talk about how crazy my week was. So I'm gonna be coming back at the chicken enchilada skillet with vegetables. Tuesday, I'm making meatloaf, potatoes, and veggies, kind of that home-cooked hearty meal on Tuesday. Wednesday is a one-pot chicken dinner. This is a 30-minute meal, you guys. Sounds amazing. Can't wait. Thursday, I'm going to be in my air fryer making homemade mozzarella sticks. Yes, please. And we're going to air fry some chicken as well. And then Friday is going to be leftovers. So on the back of the actual weekly menu is where I will plan my meal prep. So I prep every week breakfast, lunch, and some sort of a snack. So really excited for this week. So for breakfast this week, I'm going to be having comfort food breakfast bake. The weather is changing. I'm definitely feeling a little bit more the comfort food vibe. So I can't wait to share that with you guys. For lunches, I'm gonna be doing the Copycat Panera Asian Chicken Salad. I cannot wait for this. I've been craving salads again. I'm in the salad mood. So I'm gonna be doing this and I'm gonna top it with some chicken. So it's going to be a full, comprehensive, low point, delicious, healthy lunch. And I'm gonna be making homemade pumpkin pudding just to have as a dessert one night. I believe it makes 4 servings. So we actually can have it for a couple of nights. Super low points, and we're getting into pumpkin season. And also, I am planning on doing my first fall baking series. I'm not gonna share with you the recipe, it's a surprise. But that is what's on my meal plan for the week. Again, this is my Carrie L meal planner. If you are interested in picking up this meal planner, my 10% off discount code is here on the screen. Click the link down in the description box, enter the code, you'll get 10% off. Highly recommend. It is definitely a way to stay on track, to plan your meals, and it just helps you in your weight loss journey in general. So definitely recommend the Carrie L. Thank you for joining me on this week's WW Grocery Haul. I hope you enjoyed seeing all of the good stuff that I picked up for the upcoming week, my meal plan, what I'm doing for meal prep, and of course, I can't wait to share with you my first ever 2019 fall baking series video. I am not going to give away what we're making, but I can't wait. It sounds amazing. The smart points are great. So I can't wait to share that with you coming shortly. You'll be seeing tons of fall baking, Halloween baking, Christmas baking. We do it all around here. So if you are new to my channel, make sure that you hit that subscribe button and that little bell. That way you'll be notified every time I upload. You don't want to miss a single video, especially with the holidays and Vlogmas right around the corner. I'd love it if you thumbs up this one. Comment down below. Let me know what you thought of this week's grocery haul and what on my meal plan or meal prep are you most excited about. And I'll see you guys all in my next video. Bye.